加拿大副总理兼财政部长弗里兰在国会发布秋季经济报告，弗里兰强调，这不是一份完整的预算案，而是对疫情期间政府各项援助计划的总结，包括针对中低收入家庭的托儿补助、年轻人就业计划、发展绿色经济、个人防护用品税务减免、像在加拿大售卖电子产品或服务的外国公司、电商平台的短租服务、开征商品及服务税等。
This fall economic statement outlines the government of Canada's measures to fight and defeat COVID-19, to support Canadians through this crisis, and to rebuild Canada's economy once the virus is beaten.
官方反对党联邦保守党党领奥图尔批评特鲁多政府疫情期间创下近4000亿加元的赤字，却在国民急需的疫苗和快速病毒检测方面毫无计划，更无法带领加拿大国民走出危机，重建经济。
What is the plan for rolling out the vaccine? When does it arrive? Who gets it first? Do we have the freezers for the -70 vaccine, Mr. Speaker?A robust portfolio in 2023 doesn't help us as we enter 2021.
联邦新民主党则建议，政府应该对全国的超级富豪开征财富税，以弥补各项疫情援助带来的巨大财务缺口。最新报告显示，在今年新冠肺炎疫情期间，加拿大最富裕的44人财富增加了530亿加元。
So we're looking at a wealth tax on those who've got fortunes of over 20 million, on a pandemic profiteering tax, those companies, large corporations that have made massive profits during the pandemic off of people's backs, they should be the ones that are paying.
凤凰卫视主客卿吴景黄山温哥华报道。